anything you do during your studies will help you. I actually like your channel, and I like your idea of inducting interviews with others, because this is a misunderstanding from students, probably, situation. GPAs do not really guarantee you a job. You should learn to speak up also when there's something wrong. You should learn how to do public speeches. What will help you to get to know those stuff right here is to have a working student job while you are studying, or having an internship.
Hello everyone, today we have Ms. Sham Alshain, who is currently working as a data scientist at Siemens Healthineers. And today we are going to have some kind of amazing conversation around data science topics and how to build a career around data science, machine learning, all these kind of technical stuff. At the same time, we are going to have some kind of conversation around career guidance too. So first of all, Sham, thank you very much for your spending your time out of your busy day.
Hi, Samir. Thank you for having me. I'm really happy to be with you and to answer your questions. And actually, at my end, it's now around 10. At my end, it's actually around 10:45 minutes. So we are in the morning, you are in the afternoon, or in the noontime.
Yeah. Okay. So first of all, what did you do as a data scientist at presently at Siemens Healthineers, and how did how does your 9-to-5 day looks like from morning? Like, what are the exact tasks are involved in your daily task, and what are the projects that you will work upon mostly, and how actually it will work out?
As you know, data science is really a wide range of fields. So you don't have one task, you don't have one type of job. It's really different jobs in one title, as we call it, like a blanket title. So depending on my task, my day will differ. So if I am working with a big group of people and colleagues, I will definitely have a stand-up meeting. We will go through the steps for the day, the tasks for the day, and what to do, and how to solve some problems. If I'm working alone, of course, it's also different. I will be doing data cleansing and data modeling, and preparing my data for my dashboards, because I do mainly visualization right now. Also, I sometimes work with log files, where I have to screen the log files which comes from machines and look for the important information to extract it by applying some patterns. So it's really different. It's between software engineering, data analysis, machine learning engineering. It's really different. So but you are always busy, definitely. And most of the day, you have presentations that you have to. You have presentations to do most of the day, and basically, yeah, the day will finish before you know.
Okay, fine. It's cool, really. Okay, coming to next one. Like, Sham, can you share your journey or your pathway from university to present data scientist? Like, the thing was, it was really very amazing to understand how you become a data scientist. Like, a lot of people have their own paths, and a lot of articles are available on the internet which suggest many different kinds of techniques to become a data scientist. Maybe it was really very interesting to know how you, like, what is the exact strategy that you apply in your life to end up in like a data scientist? Yeah.
If you look few years back, I don't think there was a program that is specifically for data science. This is in my opinion. For example, I studied medical engineering, and I also studied in my bachelor mechanical engineering and electrical engineering. Okay. And electronic engineering. So I wasn't really built up to be a data scientist before. But when I came to Germany, I did my master's degree in computer science. It was also medical engineering, but it was in the chair of computer science. And the courses we were taking were really in the direction of data science and software engineering. All the stuff about computer vision, image processing, and data processing. And this is how I started to get into this field. Then I started taking some online courses just by self-interest. It was just out of curiosity.
Yeah.
And then you go to interviews, you realize this is really what the current employee, what the current employers are looking for. So they are looking for someone who could solve the problem for them, who could work with big data. You should have those skills where you are really able to clean the big piles of data. Usually at the university, you have this really beautiful set of data, which you will just apply machine learning or deep learning on them, or even computer vision tasks. But in real world, in real life, the data is not like that. The data is so ugly.
Yeah.
It doesn't have the best quality for working with algorithms. So you start to step into the steps which comes before machine learning and deep learning. And there where you also start to look into the other fields of data science. I also got an honor degree from Udacity as a scholarship. And this also opened the doors for me as well. I did my master thesis in this topic. And I definitely had a great time. I also tried to, I was trying to involve myself in every topic that includes data science in there. So I participated in hackathons, we built apps, we built dashboards. I also participated, I took part also in a nonprofit, which is called Medical Data Donors, which aims at the idea of collecting medical data for researchers to be used for free. I can also tell you and give more about it or give you the link to it. So all of those stuff were kind of giving me the chance to become a data scientist. Of course, you cannot be an expert in one field. Your studies will prepare you to be aware of everything going around you. And you add on top of that some online courses and some things you do on your own. And there you start to become an expert in one thing at least. Of course, at work, you will always have the chance to learn more about the other parts.
Yeah, exactly.
Or the other fields.
Yeah, it's very, very true. Like, apart from academics, presently I am doing my bachelor's in computer science engineering, specialization of data analytics. And apart of my academics, I mostly work upon any kind of such kind of hackathons or competitions in Kaggle. Like, I am presently in my third year and just completed my third year first semester, like right 1 week before. And also planning to do my master's in Germany. I think.
Cool.
Yeah, I think from this September, the applications will be open and I will start applying to different kinds of universities in Germany in phase of data science and analytics. And,
come over to FAU. I studied in Friedrich Alexander Universität, and it's also known as FAU in German, FAU in English. So it's a very well-known university, and I think if you come here, you will really be satisfied. There are a variety of programs that cover this kind of topics, and I think you will be happy.
Yeah.
I will tell you, studying in Germany is not easy. It's not easy. You will have to, of course, go through a learning curve, but you will have fun, and I hope also you will find a job, because this topic is the hype topic at the moment. Anything you do during your studies will help you. I actually like your channel, and I like your idea of inducting interviews with others, because when I was looking for a job and when I was also looking for a working student position or looking for my master degree, the master program, I also conducted interviews. I started asking people through LinkedIn, and I started asking people that I know. I started really asking everyone, literally. But I didn't record it. I think what you are doing is really great, because you share the knowledge and you organize your thoughts. You really ask the questions that you are looking for answers.
And coming to our next question, like since you talk about your data science generally, mostly drawing insights from data and making business decisions and cleaning lots of international data, so is like one of my friend asked to me that is storytelling is really important in data science?
Yeah, basically as a data science or at the university, you are focusing on learning algorithms, classical machine learning algorithms, how to code, how to debug, those stuff. Some courses would give you the chance to do this kind of pitching or presenting your idea, making this kind of story to tell about what you have done in your project. And each and every chance of this kind you should have and you should take. I would suggest in the meantime, while you are studying, really to focus on this kind of skills, like you said, storytelling, because it's important. It's really important because you might be the only data scientist in your team, or you might work or present to other people or stakeholders. The people you are talking to or presenting to might not know how to program or might not know about the algorithms you are talking about. So you have to always pick simple words. You have to make it clear. You have to answer questions. Actually, you have to make your talk as the same principle you use also when you are studying. When you are preparing for an exam, you should be able to explain things as you are explaining it to your grandma or to your little brother or your little sister. So it's the same concept. You have to be very clear, you have to be very simple, and you have to make the idea reach to everyone in the audience. Regardless of their backgrounds.
Yeah, that's the exact point. Yeah. Like, coming to next question. Next part was, do we really need a kind of good CGPA or a kind of good degree for placing as any kind of tech role? Like, for example, data scientist at top companies like FANG? Yeah.
I would say there is a misunderstanding from students probably. I was also in the same situation. GPAs do not really guarantee you a job. And actually in all my interviews, I was never asked about my GPA. The only time I was asked for my GPA when I applied for the master degrees, for the master degree. But in any other position or location, I was really not asked about my GPA. I was more asked about my skills, my knowledge, what projects I did. Because this is what is important for the one who is employing you. It's not your grades. You might have a A+ or a GPA, like the German GPA 1.0, but you don't really understand what is going on, then this is wrong. You have to be flexible, you have to know how to grasp the concepts, and of course collecting grades is really good, it makes you feel good, and of course it's important to have a good GPA.
Yeah.
But it's I would say people who are hiring would not definitely look on the GPA. It might be one of the criteria that maybe if two people are exactly the same with everything, both of them, the hiring manager like them, then it might be the only criteria which differs them. Of course, then he would pick the one with a higher GPA or a better GPA. But it's definitely not the first criteria they look at.
Yeah, exactly.
This is what I believe. This is from my experience.
So Shyam, thank you very much for your time. I think this was really an amazing conversation, and I'm pretty sure the people are going to find it really, really, very helpful and informative too. And thank you very much. Have a great day.
Thank you. You too. Thank you so much also for having me. I was so glad to meet you and get to know you. You're absolutely a great person. I like your personality and I like the way you are encouraged to do things. So thank you so much again.
Yeah, it's really my pleasure.
Keep in touch.
Yeah, sure, why not? Send the rocks across the state.